Welcome to Programming Hunk, and I am Pushpendra.
Welcome back. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss prepared statement in JDBC. We will create a simple application to understand how the prepared statement objects are used. Before moving with this tutorial, you must be aware with the basics of JDBC. For that, you can follow the links given in the description box. So basically, prepared statement is an interface which is derived from the statement interface itself. Statement objects become difficult to handle sometime because the variables and the objects are embedded into a string to form a SQL statement, and that statement string can become very difficult to understand and interpret sometimes, especially when we have multiple SQL statements to execute in single method. The best thing about the prepared statement is that they are very easy to use and very convenient. A prepared statement object is given a pre-compiled SQL statement when it is created. Unlike a normal statement object, which is given a simple string SQL statement. The advantage is that this SQL statement will be sent to the DBMS directly, where it can be executed without a recompilation most of the times. This will improve the efficiency as a result, and the prepared statement objects will execute faster and efficiently than the normal simple statement objects. To understand prepared statement, we are going to create a simple application. For this, we are going to create four packages with four classes. The first package will be the utility package, and a utility class will be placed inside this package. Second package will be a bean package, and the bean class or the data model will be placed in this class. Third class will be DAO class or the data access object class, and this will be placed in the DAO package. And the fourth class will be for the user interaction or the class having a main method, and this will be placed in the main package. Now let's move to the Eclipse IDE. First of all, we will create a project and provide it some name and just click the finish. So the project is ready. Now we need to add the database driver to this project. I have already downloaded OJDBC8. You can also download it and use. We have already discussed this in previous tutorial. Add this to the build path. Select where you have downloaded it and add to the build path of your project. This will be visible in your project structure. Now you can create first class in the bean package, and let me create a new class with the name car. So we are going to store and retrieve the data of a car from the database. Now I'm creating the second class in the util package, and let me name it DB connection, and all the connection objects will be created by this class, and we will create a static method in this class. Third package is the DAO package, and we will create the DAO class in this package. Let the name be car DAO, and the fourth class will be simple UI class, and the main method will be placed in this class. So we will also select public static void main, right? So all four classes are created as we have earlier discussed. So this is the project structure. Now we need to add some fields to the car bean, and all these fields must be private. So let the fields be car ID, model, brand, and the color. Because we are creating a bean, so all of these fields will be private, and we will add a whole field constructor to this class. So just right click or go to the source and select field constructor with the fields, and the constructor is created here. So we also will be adding the getter and setter methods. Procedure is same, just go to the source and select getter and setter methods for all the fields or properties in this class. So bean class is created. Now we can create the utility class, and we will create a method which will return the connection object for us, because in almost every method we need a connection object. So we are creating a static method so that we are not going to code this many times. First of all, we need to load the driver. For this, we can use class.forName method, and we will write the name of the driver here. You need to remember this string. This is oracle.jdbc.driver.oracle-driver. Then you will get the connection object from the driver manager class. Handle the exception because the class not found exception can occur here. So you can get the connection object from the driver manager, because driver manager class contains carries all the data of the all the drivers available. You need to pass the URL first, that is JDBC colon oracle colon thin colon at the rate localhost colon 1521, which is the which is the port, and XE, this is a version of my database, that is Express Edition. So you need to write this code. Okay, so you will get the connection object from here. Now we are moving to the DAO class, and we will create the data access object in this class. First of all, we are going to create a method which will create a table in the database, and that table will store the data of a car. So connection is already created in the DB connection class, so we can get the connection object from there. We directly need to create a statement object, right? So a statement object is created. We need to pass the query into this statement, that is create table, name of the table, right? So this is a simple statement object, not a prepared statement object. I'm just writing the query here. This is a simple query in the Oracle database. I'm providing it the name of the columns, and I will also provide it the primary key. And this is the exact mapping of the bean class. We are having four fields in the bean class car, same four fields we are having in the table. The query is composed here, and we can execute this query on our statement object, but we need to first handle this exception. This is a SQL exception, so I'm just enclosing it in try catch block. Now I can execute this query like this, execute and SQL your SQL query. I'm also writing a little message here that the table is created successfully, so we are aware that the table is created or not. Correct. So this is our first method to create a table. Now we can create the other methods. The second method should be to insert some data into the table. For this, we will add the data of a car into the table. For this, we will pass the car object as the parameter into the insert data method. I am fetching all the fields from the car object first, then I will add them into the query, and we will then execute the query. So first of all, we need to get the connection object, which we will get from the DB connection class. Correct. Now we are creating the prepared statement object. One of the major advantages of prepared statement object is that we do not need to embed these variables into the SQL query. We will put question marks where we are going to put these variables. So I am going to put four variables in my SQL query. So I have placed four question marks at their place. Now I will use the supplier methods to supply them values. So at the first index of the question marks, at the first index, value is ID, then the model. At second index, at third index, the brand, and at the fourth index, that is color. So I'm supplying all these four values using the supplier methods. I'm using setInt and setString supplier methods, as their data types are specified. Correct. So this makes prepared statement very convenient and easy in comparison to the statement object, where we have to embed the simple string with the variables. Now we are done with the insert data method, and I have written a message for the successful updation of the table, and I have also written a message that table is not updated if some exception has occurred. Now I can create a new method to show all the data in the table. For this, let the name of the method be show data, and first of all I am going to get the connection object from the DB connection class. Get connection method, which is static. Correct. Now you can create the prepared statement object again and prepare a statement and pass the SQL query into this object, that is select asterisk from car. Car is the name of the table. Correct. And just to handle the exception, which is the SQL exception. And here you need to run the execute query method, which will return a result set. And from this result set, we can fetch the data. Result set is nothing but the row column representation of the fetched data. Correct. So this is the next method, which will keep us in the loop, and we can use the get methods for fetching the values from the RES object. Right. So I have just prepared a string here to display the data, and we are done with this method now. Correct. We have created three methods in the CarDAO class, and now we can test them first, then we will move forward. First of all, we will create a table in the database. For this, I am creating the CarDAO object first, and I can invoke create table method with this object. So running this method, the table is created successfully. Correct. Now I need to comment this. I will never run this method again, otherwise it will throw exception. Now I can insert the data into the table. For this, I need to pass an object of class car into this data, into this method. All right, so this is an object of car I'm inserting into the, so we can see that the table is updated successfully. It means one row is created in the database. Now we can add few more rows into the table. I'm running the second query here. Okay, table is updated. I am again changing the values and running this. Correct. So we can run this again. Table is again updated successfully. So few data is available in our table, and we can see the data using the show data method. As you can see here, our table is having three rows. So this is how prepared statement is working. These statements are carrying pre. So we are again going to create a new method to delete an entire row from the table. For this, I'm creating a new method. Let the name of the method be remove data, and we will pass the ID of the car, and the data of that car will be deleted from the database. For this, we need to update the query first. So I'm making the changes in the query first. This will be deleted from the car, where the ID is, and I will put a question mark here. I need to provide only one variable here, which is the ID. Correct. Now I also just need single supplier method to provide the value of ID, and I'm just updating the messages for the user here, and we can see if the code is working correctly or not, our fourth method is working or not. So fourth method is remove data. Correct. I have passed the ID of the car, and we will first see the data in the table. Okay, there are three cars. Now I will run this method. After running this method, okay, there is some error or exception. As you can see, the SQL command is not properly ended, so we need to check what is the problem with the SQL query in the car DAO class. Right, this is the problem. We need to remove this parenthesis from here and save this and run this program again. So you can see now, you can see there are only two rows left now. One row is deleted. This is how prepared statement works.
Thank you for watching. Like, share, subscribe, and comment.